हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज मी ऋषभ एंड वेलकम अगेन टू माय न्यू पॉडकास्ट। एंड हियर वी हैव मिस्टर जीत। हेलो मिस्टर जीत, कैन यू हियर मी?
Yes, I can hear you. Hi, how are you?
या आई एम डूइंग ग्रेट। सो मिस्टर जीत, वेरी गुड इवनिंग। सो मिस्टर जीत, कैन यू इंट्रोड्यूस योर सेल्फ सो दैट आवर लिसनर कैन गेट अबाउट यू?
Yeah, sure. This is Jeet. I'm from Punjab State and I live at Ludhiana City. So basically, I'm a government employee and I'm working in a health department as a senior executive. And it's been 2 years to me. I've been working under NHM and my work totally related to accounts department.
Okay, related to accounts department. And Mr. Jeet, like if I ask about your qualifications, so what are the qualifications have you
Yeah,
completed?
actually, you will be astonished because my qualification doesn't match my profile. So I've done my MPhil in English literature.
Okay, fine, fine. And like you are doing job in MNC?
No, actually, I'm not working in an MNC. I'm working under government.
Okay, you are
So it's a
working.
government department. But in many states, NHM can be found as a scheme. Some employees are on regularly basis, whereas many employees are on unregular basis. So fortunately, I'm on a regularly basis.
Okay, so like what kind of job you do? Because this job what you have told, I think it's quite
Actually,
new for me.
yeah, my job contains lots of responsibility. Firstly, we look upon the schemes which has been launched by the center government, how many patients are being treated under the schemes and the revenue of the hospital, moreover the salary of doctors or nurses. So these are the few rules or responsibility of mine on my job.
Okay, fantastic, because the term was quite new for me. And like,
yeah.
Mr. Jeet, like if I talk about your future plan, that like what is your short term and long term goals, like after, like you're doing right now a job, I think you would be earning, so what is your like goal, like what is your short term and long term goal?
Actually, short term goal right now, I have been teaching to the students regarding IELTS preparation, and I have been running one Instagram page too.
Okay.
Anybody can follow that Instagram page. It's IELTS Trainer 9.
Okay.
And
fantastic.
I have made few videos people can follow. It would be convenient for them.
Yeah.
So for a long term, I have applied for permanent residence in Canada because I have taken all the international exams such as TOEFL, IELTS, PTE, and I do have great experience in it. Since beginning, I just wanted to work in a department where I can do some creative, because I have love with the English language. I wanted to get a job in the news department, but I was not lucky because I born in a Punjab and I didn't want to migrate because I'm a single child of my parents. They didn't let me go anywhere. Therefore, I started preparation for competitive exams and I got a job. So therefore, whenever I will migrate myself in the broad country, as I told you, I've applied for permanent residence, then I'll try to rejuvenate my skills and will try to get a job in the news channel or newspaper as an anchor or editor.
Okay, that's quite fantastic. So you want to get as a job as an anchor or something. And so like, what is your main motive to go to Canada? Because like already, like because some people go for the job or something and you still have a job in India. So what is the main motive or main reason? Because everybody have different reasons. Some want to go for job, some want to go for learning some skills, some want to go for different reasons. So what
Okay.
is your main reason or main motive?
Okay, so it's a nice question. Usually before answering this question, I would like to tell you why people migrate in a broad country. Usually there are five reasons, as you told me. Firstly, people migrate themselves in a broad country for higher education.
Okay,
and secondly, people go for job opportunity because India has been suffering from unemployment crisis and no
exactly
politician has been caring about it, so which is a main issue in India.
Okay,
and
exactly.
Thirdly, people go over there for a better treatment, such as when Jaitley
health.
Was ill, then Jaitley migrated in America in order to get a better health facilities, and our poor health facilities can be seen in the COVID-19 when we had very less ventilators. So therefore, people migrate themselves because people want to get a good health facilities.
Exactly.
And the fourth point of view, people migrating themselves in a broad country because people want to enjoy the lifestyle. In a broad country, Western countries, people don't have mean with you. Where do you come from? And whether you have castle, but you want to sleep on a footpath, you can. People don't have any mean. Whereas in India, people love to interrupt other people's life. Why you do this thing? How you do? And so this is not good. Many people don't like it. So therefore, they migrate. And fifth, I would like to point out on my community, especially from Punjab, many people have migrated in Canada. So therefore, my whole classmates, my half of my family members are living over there, who have been encouraging me and have been telling me the life is much easier over here because of lots of jobs, and the government cares about you, whether you have been working as a laborer or as an officer. You have equal facilities, equal privileged by the government. So these are the five things why people migrate in a broad country. Now I'm gonna tell you why I'm gonna migrate. So firstly, as I told you, I do have government job, but I just want to explore the world. And because nations have divided by the people, God has given us a one beautiful earth. We have separated it. We have made, this is our national language. This is our not national language. This is a foreign language for us. So firstly, I just want to explore the world, and I don't want to rely on the Canada also. After settling my business in Canada, I will try to invest some money in India, because India is really very good for foreign investment. And whenever my business will be established, then I will go for a world tour.
Okay, world tour. Okay,
Yes.
fantastic. So, like, which kind of business you want to start in abroad, like in Canada, which kind of business you want to start?
Actually, I'm lucky because my elder brother has been living in Canada in a Brampton, and he does have his own restaurant known as Punjabi Chatka, where they have been selling meat, which is usually made in India, the curry chicken and that
Butter
kind of
chicken.
things, which people don't like to eat. Spicy, India known for spices.
Yeah, exactly.
So I will get branch of my brother restaurant, and I will open that restaurant in Toronto, which is a nearby city of the Brampton.
Exactly. So just one question just I was having that, like, what are the things required? Like, can anyone start a business there, or what are the things required to start a business?
Okay, so it's little bit typical because Canada does have lots of rules or regulation which are really very strict instead of India. If anybody wants to start their own business in Canada, then person must have 10,000 hours experience in their own country regarding one business.
Okay, 10,000 hours.
Yeah, 10,000 hours. Then individual can get permission from the Canadian government and can start their business. Yeah, so this is the one requirement. Moreover, if anybody has been doing any business like import export in India, that person can contract and can consult with the brand such as Amazon, Walmart, which is very strong chain of the malls. So such as if one individual have been selling vegetables and want to import or export in any country, then can contact with the Walmart, and that company will give you lots of way to deal with them, and they will sell your product while putting their tag on that vegetables, but you can easily enhance your business.
Exactly. Fantastic. So you told I have got some detail about the business also, and just as you said that you are teaching to IELTS student. So, like, can
Yes.
you a little bit emphasize about IELTS? Like, I know about IELTS. Okay, like those who don't know about IELTS, so can you little bit say about IELTS? After that, I will
Okay.
ask some question.
Yeah, why not? And it's a IELT exam, and short form we say it IELTS. So usually there are four modules, and the full form of this exam I would like to tell you firstly. What is the full form of this exam? The full form of this exam is International English Language Testing System. So there are four modules in this exam. Firstly, reading, and individual will have to go through with the 9,000 words
Okay,
within
9,000
one
words.
hour, and will have to find the 40 questions. There would be many types of the questions, such as filling the blanks and multiple choice question, matching the headlines and summary. So these type of questions can be found by the individual or by the people. And this reading will be divided in the three section, three passages and 13 questions. Secondly, there is a speaking. Individual will have to come across with the examiner. That examiner would be certified and trained by the Cambridge University. So interview will be conducted within 14 minutes. Firstly, exam will start from the introduction, your name, passport detail, and after that one topic will be given to you by the examiner, and you will have to speak on that topic continuously for 2 minutes. You should have good vocabulary, connectors, each and everything if you want to get 8 score out of 9. Usually each and every module get value of 9 bands. Okay, so this is a speaking, and after speaking on that topic, which will be given by the examiner will start topic discussion. That means related the questions regarding the topic. I would like to give you the example, such as If I have asked you, describe the book which you have read last year.
Oh my God.
From where did you get this book? What have you learned from this book? And what have you implemented, which you have learned from this book, what you have implemented in your regular life?
Okay,
So
fantastic.
after speaking 2 minutes, examiner would ask the same questions regarding the topic, such as how many people in India read books, and what do you think, what kind of books people need to read? So it will contain rest of the minutes of your interview. Approximately, totally, you will have to continuously speak 14 minutes, and it would be challenging because you will get the topics which you never come across. So
Oh my
usually
God.
I provide a special training for this thing, personality development. It's also
Personality.
known in a one course. Yeah.
Exactly.
So the third module is writing module.
Okay.
And if you want to go for academic, then you will have to come across with the writing task, one in which you will have to see bar chart and pie chart, maps, flow chart, process chart. So these kind of things, information would be provided by the examiner, and you will have to elaborate that information with a systematical way. There would be a writing task too.
Okay.
And you individual will have to write 250 words on that passage.
Okay.
250 words, and you should have unique ideas, and you will have to give introduction and two paragraphs, which known BP1, BP2, and after that a conclusion. So this is really very heavy budget. That means writing task one doesn't get that much value, how much writing task two
Too good.
gets. So last but not least, listening. One listening will be provided by the examiner, and it will contain 25 minutes, and pupil will have to answer 40 questions.
40 questions. Okay.
Yeah, so these are the four modules in IELTS exam. Usually there are two types of IELTS exam. One is academic, if any individual wants to migrate on the study visa. Second is GT, such as professional doctors, engineers, barber, and chef want to migrate themselves in any abroad country. Usually the preference of people UK and Canada, America, Australia, New Zealand, because these countries are really very amiable with the immigrants. So that individual will have to go through with the IELTS GT. There is no any change. The change can be seen in the reading. In academic, there are three topics, whereas in a GT reading, individual will have to go through with the five passages. The wording would be same, 9,000. And the writing task will be totally different. In a GT, writing task will be normal life related writing tasks, such as hotel and employees, and mother should take a maternity leave. So these kind of topics can be seen, whereas in a academic, individual will have to write the research topics. So this is the distinction with the both exams.
Okay, fantastic. So, like you said, the four modules, okay, reading, writing, listening, and so which is the most difficult one? Like, what
Reading
according
is
to
the most difficult one.
reading?
Yeah, there
Okay.
are many reasons after it. First and foremost, people don't have rich vocabulary. People know only one word. People don't know synonyms, such as many people say, people is a word. Like, let's take example of the people. So what are the synonyms? People, individuals,
Person.
folks, masses. So these are the five synonyms which can be used sequentially, because in IELTS we cannot repeat the same word and same sentence formation if you want to get a great scores. So reading, why people are unable? Firstly, the time is always a barrier. It's not easy to read 9,000 words
Oh my God.
speedily within 1 hour, and you have to find the answers also. So, but with the help of practice, people can get good scores, because I do have students who get 32, 33 out of 40, and their score is 7, 7.5, or even 8 also.
Exactly. And like what after comes, or like after reading, like as you said, that reading is quite like a little bit difficult. So after reading, what comes? Like how, if I will tell you to prioritize all the things, so what will come after next and next?
Okay, so should I start from easier or should I start from the
Yeah,
difficult?
you can start from the difficult one.
Okay, so reading is one of the difficult module in IELTS. Second, the toughest, writing task too, because usually people don't get ideas, and representation, don't know how to put the connectors and what kind of connectors are required for IELTS. And thirdly, people face difficulty in speaking, because it's not easy to speak continuously, especially on the
Speaking.
topic. and people have to represent because interviews always pressurize whether you are mature or immature, because interview is a phobia and interview brings nervousness because this is your exam. Whether you're going for a work interview, you have always some expectations. You just want to get that job, but you have to compete with the people. So you can understand the interview is always nervousness for people. So therefore, on a third number, I will put speaking, and on a fourth number, I will put listening.
Listening, okay.
Listening is easy. I have seen individuals to get 9 out of 9 scores also, because one recording will be played. You just need to get the answers, what other people have been saying.
So like how much I have to score in IELTS so that I can go abroad?
Usually, if you want to go for a study visa, then if you are plus two student, then your requirement is 6 in each module, not less than 6.
Okay, each module.
Oh yeah, each module pupil has to be gotten 6. Whereas if you want to go after bachelor, then the requirement is being enhanced by the Canadian universities. You must have 6.5 overall or 7.
6.5 to 7.
Yeah, if you want to migrate after masters, you have done MPhil in English or MA in English, Master of Arts, and MB, any degree you have done related to masters, then you must score 7.5 or 8, because universities don't take the less scores, because universities think you have done great qualification in your country and your level must be high. Now, I would like to talk about the GT professional, such as doctors, engineer, chef. So usually, you know, chef or nurses, they do technical work. They don't talk, they don't deal with people. So they just work, chefs just work in a kitchen, just serve the dishes, whereas nurses just work on the command of doctor. They need not to talk with many patients. The doctor just tell them vaccine, they vaccinate the patients. So therefore, these professions demand less bands. People can migrate on a permanent residence on the band of 6, whereas doctors, teachers, professors, and engineers, these people do the job which is accountable job. So therefore, their requirement is high. They must take 8 overall and 8.5 also, such as I have applied for administration job, and I will get job in a bank or in a grocery store where I will have to deal with the public. Therefore, I should have good communication skills.
Exactly. So like okay, so you said all things. So like one thing I want to say that as you would like train people for IELTS, so like what is the suggestion would you like to give to the people? Like what is the tips would you like to give to the people? Like those who are listening us, they want to go, they are preparing for IELTS or want to go abroad. So what you want to give them suggestion that how can they prepare and get good bands in IELTS?
Firstly, motivation. People have lack of motivation. Whenever any pupil prepare for any exam, they think this is not cup of tea for them because they get pressure. So firstly, motivation. Secondly, don't spend too much time on the preparation. Just give your 100%, because you cannot run your preparation for a long time, such as IAS exam. Those exams do have lots of diversity, such as economics and chemistry, GK. Here are many parts of the GK because I have been through with that exam. Whereas in IELTS, it's all about the language. And just do preparation for 3 months and fill your exam. Check your capability, because this is not a UPSC exam. This exam not like a Kumbh fair, which comes after 4 years. So organization provide 4 chances in a month. You can fill your exam unlimited time. Do the preparation, check your capability, and give your 100%. Be motivated and try to be in the target language, such as English.
So like the I think when I talk to some of the people, okay, so they face mainly the problem in speaking. Okay, so like how they can improve themselves like in speaking, because the people, those who listen us, mostly they want to improve their speaking skills or want to improve their English or want to improve their communication skills. So what suggestion would you like to give to them how they can improve their speaking? Okay, as you are also a good speaker, you can also speak too good in English and in communication skills. So what suggestion would you like to give and how you have improved like this?
Actually, my journey has been taken lots of time. As I told you, I took admission Bachelor of Arts, and my major was English. And after that, I have done my MA in English and MPhil in English too. So therefore, 7 years I've spent in my study, and there were lots of courses which were provided by my university free of cost, how to speak, how to interact with public, and I took participate in lots of debate, and I took participate in lots of competitions. I used to write the speaks. I used to work as a freelancer because I'm a good content writer.
Oh my God,
So it's been long journey. If any beginner listen me and want to speak like me, then that beginner needs lots of practice. But I would like to give some shortcuts how people can improve themselves. Firstly, English grammar is one of the important thing. I have heard from many people, they just want to speak without grammar. It's possible. If individual have good vocabulary and individual knows the meaning of the words, such as many people don't know the meaning of was, have, had, and they don't have rich vocabulary, how they those people can speak without grammar. So therefore, it was said by my professor, if any individual wants to get mastery on any language, firstly individual have to get mastery on the grammar.
Grammar,
Yeah, grammar is the shortcut in order to become fluent early in the English language. Secondly, there are many applications which can be used by individuals, such as OpenTalk, Hello application. These are the two example of them.
Means you only
And
say
what
practice.
it's only for practice, and there are very rare chance to get a good people, but there are some good peoples with whom individuals can practice. The first starting of any beginner from the translation, and the next step, think in the target language and speak in the target language. That means create an environment. And so third level, intermediate level, where individual can start talking a topic. Any topic can be picked by the individual, such as discipline, Indian education system, Indian polity, and can start discussion or debate with other people, which will pressurize, because without pressurize, individual cannot do efforts or strive to make themselves improve or be affluent. So these are the ways which can be used. I would like to give you the brief idea. Firstly, go through with the English grammar and enhance your vocabulary. Individuals can listen and can write down in familiar words. Don't forget to cram those words in every morning, and try to make sentences also. And whenever individual talk with anybody, individuals can use those words and try to talk on a topic. Many topics can be found on a Google: burning issues and current matters, such as farmer agitation is being happened in India. So individuals can talk and can share. It will not only improve or enhance the knowledge of individual, but also will assist them to be fluent in English language. So these are the things which can be done by any person who wants to be good in any language.
Fantastic. So I think you gave a very good and great point. And so,
Yeah.
Mr. Jeet, so if I want to ask about, like, what is your interest? Like, what is your hobby? So, like, what do you would you like to do in free time? So, what would you like to say?
Actually, I'm very busy person, and those people are lucky who do have lots of time. So, but today I would like to tell what I do in my leisure time. I'm too much enthusiastic regarding fitness. So therefore,
Fitness.
in this lockdown, after ending this lockdown, I've joined boxing classes, and I learned boxing. I have learned so many tricks. That means I can beat so many people. Not
Oh my
I'm not that much profession, but it's really very necessary for self-defense,
God.
and
Yeah,
it has become my hobby. And I have been working out since 10 years because my elder brother, he's a fitness manager. He has done lots of courses. He has done MA in like a physical fitness and nutrition expert. I don't know how many courses he has done. So therefore, from him I got this interest. And the gym I
Fitness
was
freak.
doing before starting boxing. So these are the two things which you can include in my hobby, which is meditation for me, give me relax from my genuine work or teaching. Secondly, sometime I watch Netflix series. I have seen so many series: Stranger Things, Money Heist, so many.
So, like, mostly which type of series would you like to watch? Like, what kind of series you watch? Like, because there are a
Actually,
lot of series with a different thing, like thrill, some love stories, and some like about on business. So, which one would you like to mostly you go for?
actually,
Motivation.
I go with the sci-fi.
Sci-fi, what is that?
It's a scientifically research.
Okay, scientifically
Yeah,
research.
so I have watched Altered Carbon, which is my one of the favorite series. Many people would not like that because they have used lots of technology in this web series. Many people think it cannot be possible, but I saw the imagination of the director, how much advanced that director could have thought, which many people cannot even think now. So this is my favorite series, and I would like to give you, people can watch whatever they like, the area of their interest.
Area of the interview. Yeah, exactly. Because every person doesn't like to watch same thing. Like, some will watch motivational, some will watch love story. So everybody have their different perception and different way of thinking.
Yeah,
Okay, sir.
absolutely right.
Okay, so Mishajit, like one question I was want to ask, that as you want to go Canada, so I think some sounds are coming from your background.
Yeah, actually, there is some work going on in my house. So sorry for that. Even I'm also getting disturbance.
Okay, no problem. So just
Yeah.
I want to ask that, can anyone go to Canada, or for going Canada a person should have some skills or something, or anyone can just go to Canada? So what is the answer? Like,
Anyone can migrate in any country, not only in Canada, but also people can migrate another countries also.
yeah, so
But what
yeah,
is
but
the required to survive in abroad country if
yeah.
person does have skills, such as if you know how to work on the barbery shop, and if you are a good cook, then it would be easy for you to survive. If you
Okay.
have some experience in accounts jobs, you can easily do work because abroad country demands skills. Those people cannot survive in abroad country who doesn't know anything, who never cooked for themselves ever in their life in their home and used to live like a nabob. So those people cannot survive in abroad country because over there you will have to start from zero.
Yeah, exactly.
Whereas in India, we get each and everything which has been made by our ancestors, parents. As something we got from our parents, something we make. So it would be better for the person if person would go with some skills, whether typing skills, barber skills, and writing skills, whether a person has been working as an engineer and does have experience on the software such as SolidWorks, Delcam, how to make the designs of the alloy with anything. So it would be easy. Anybody can migrate. There are many types of visas.
So means you want to say that, like, without skill you cannot, like, you cannot survive, because in India without skills also you can have, like, so you think that in abroad, like, it is impossible to survive without skills.
No, it's not possible to survive in a broad country without skills because what will you do? That is not your country. You haven't done study over there. You don't know the history of the country. In India, we are familiar with lots of department, government offices, and how work is being done, and we can start our own business. Whereas in a broad country, you cannot even start anything without any experience.
Okay,
So
fantastic.
thereby, I just advise. Person must have some skills. It would be easier for the person to survive in that country.
Okay, like, other than skills, like, which kind of more skills they required, like, in their work profession, or anything more skills, like communication also should be good, or like what more skills a person need?
Everybody is good in a communication skills in a broad country because you have been learning their language. But there is a one job which is related to communication skills, such as public speaking. So if you are good public speaker, then many universities or even police stations would hire you as a motivational speaker in order to motivate their
Oh
workers,
my
because this is
God.
really very necessary. This is really very necessary in a broad country. They know person should be motivator. And moreover, you can work as a there are one job because it was told by one of my friend who tells the traffic rules to the children in the school.
Oh my
So
God.
individuals can get that job if you have really good communication skills. And if it's your passion, you don't want to do anything. So this job can be done by the individuals.
Okay, yeah, these things are really, like, important. Okay, so means your communication skills is also really very important to survive there.
Communication, you cannot survive in India without Hindi.
Yes.
You cannot survive in Spain without Spanish language. So therefore, communication skills are always necessary. How will you talk with the people? How will you understand them? How will you demand help from them if you don't know their language? we are unable to interact with them. So in India, whether you are good in English, but you must speak Hindi or the regional language in which state you live, because without that language, you cannot survive.
And Mr. Jeet, like, what is your, which is your dream place? Like, where do you want to go? Like, where, which is your dream place in Canada or in the world? Which is
Actually,
your favorite
my dream
destination?
country, I would like to tell you, it's a Finland.
Finland.
Yeah,
Okay.
Finland, because I'm really fond of European countries. Finland contains the rank world happiest country,
Oh my God.
and women or male have equal rights. They can do equal job. And one fact I came to know recently, the jails, that means prisons of the Finlands, are totally empty because the crime is really very less in Finland.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
So you want to go to Finland, like,
Yes,
for
I want to travel Finland. I just want to see
explore.
why and how those countries are so much better than our country. What's the mentality of the people? Whereas in India, little disputes can be found. Police is no valuable in India. That means people are trying to solve their disputes by their own, even though this is not the right which has been given by the democracy and the constitution. Whereas in Western countries, if you come across with any dispute, they directly call to the police because this is their responsibility. We cannot spoil our brain energy while fighting with other people.
Because their people, mostly they are busy, okay, and India mostly people doesn't have work, so definitely they will not give the task to others, they will only try to solve themselves.
Yeah, so this is the thing, and I will see if I will get chance, then I'll definitely visit in Finland.
Okay, Finland. So I, like, I have not, I've heard about Finland, but I don't know about the geographical area and more thing about
Actually,
Finland.
Finland is in a European province, and you might have seen the UK location.
Yeah, exactly, UK.
Yeah, so beside UK, Italy and Switzerland, Australia. So in that way, there is a Norway or Finland upper side.
So, Mr. Jeet, one more last question, that why have you selected Canada other than going to UK, Australia, or like any country, a lot of countries are there, because mostly people go to Canada, Australia, and I think UK, and they go to America also. Why especially you have chosen Canada?
Canada is really very amiable for immigrants, not only from Indian reason, but all across the world, people are interested to migrate in Canada. Firstly, why I want to go there? Because my brother has been living over there. I'm already familiar with lots of things, and I'm familiar. I have seen Canada. We are usually interact with each other through my friends. They tell me rule or regulations. I know how to travel in the bus and how many banks are there. What's the system in Canada? Therefore, I spoke a lot. And I have visited Canada twice time on the tourist visa.
Oh my
So where will you like to go? You will like to go
God.
on the place about whom you are already familiar. Secondly, Canada does have wonderful policies, and Canada is world's second largest country after Russia. And Canada does have lots of oil reservations, which Canada never used. Canada would use when oil would be disappear from the world.
Oh
Right
my
now,
God.
Canada also have been surviving on the oil which is being come from the Gulf countries.
Oh my God.
So now America has become congested because the population of America is 21 crore, which is a population across mine only mine region, Punjab state. So
Oh my God.
it's really very less population in America, but according to them, this is too much population. And there are many bigger companies such as Amazon, Google, eBay, not a eBay. So they don't have any space to extend their business, so therefore they are coming in Canada and have been making their plants over there in order to get extension. So people would have lots of work opportunity in the future also.
Okay, so, like, one more thing I want to ask. So, can those people live and survive in Canada, or those who don't have any background? Just, for example, like me, okay, I nobody is there in my Canada, okay, like some friends I have, okay. So, like, for example, no background is there in my Canada. So, can I go and survive there? Can I live there?
Now people need not to get any reference because we are blessed with the technology, Google Map. You can even book any restaurant from India in Canada. You can book the ticket. And moreover, you can make a link. Now universities have become friendly. They have been providing their portal where you can talk with the students who belong from your your country, your region.
Exactly.
Yeah, so whenever you will go in a college, that means you will make also link, so you can easily survive whether you have anyone in Canada or not, because there are many Indians. Indian always help Indians.
Yeah. So like, yeah, one more question. Okay, this is the last question, and after that I will try to end the podcast. So whenever I talk to people, okay, I get to hear this, that if you go to Canada you will become rich, or like this kind of thing. Okay, this I get to hear from people. And like, if you go to Canada you will become rich, you can come to India you will become, so these kind of things. So what is the thing around it, like what do you think, or what is
I
the
would like to remove this myth first.
real?
Canada is not bed of roses. Every country demands hard work. In Canada, why people say, but people don't know, Canadian government deducts lots of taxes. You will have to pay tax on the single dollar in Canada. Firstly, if you earn $10,000 in a month, Canadian government will deduct taxes from your per month income automatically. Canadian government does have each and every record where you work, when you started, what's your salary. You will have to pay approximately 1,500 tax. Moreover, whenever you will put gasoline, you will have to pay tax. On grocery, you will have to pay tax. The inflation level is really very less. And Canadian government provide free nurses in your old age, because people, usually children, don't love to live with their old parents. This is a trend in the Western country. So Canadian government take care of their citizens. Whether you work or not, you can survive with a $100 grocery in Canada per month, which you can earn within 6 hours or 7 hours in a day. So that means you need not to work also if you have your own home. People can become rich if you have good policies, and it will take approximately 10 years to become a rich, because firstly you will have to strive for PR. You have to spend 5 years in Canada if you are going on a student visa. After that, you will have to buy a house which will cost you 1.5 million. You will have to pay rent of that, car insurance, lots of expenses.
Okay, means it is completely a myth that, okay, like one more thing is that, like, earn in Canada and come in India you will become rich. So what is the myth between two of them, like what do you think?
You can become rich in India also. India is full with opportunities. You can start your own business. You can implement what abroad country have already implemented. You can start applications which India has been using as a third party, isn't it? So if you have mind, internet provides equal opportunity to the people, then not only in Canada but also you can become successful or rich in India. But if you are dependent on the government, always criticize the government, don't do anything, just like idle people on a street, you just talk to the people, then from where you will become rich.
Okay. So means it depend on the person, okay, depend on your hard work.
Depend on your person and depend on their ideas.
Yeah. So I think, Mr. Jeet, I think I should end up the podcast now, because I like to talk to you more. But like, if I make a long podcast, I think people will be bored, or they will not hear us completely. Okay, and they will only take half knowledge, and half knowledge is very dangerous. Yeah.
Definitely.
So, and very, very thank you, Mr. Jeet, for coming here, okay, and giving your very, very precious and valuable time for me and for my podcast. And thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you too, having me.
Yes. Good day.
Good day, dear.